Hello everyone and welcome to the series PIB 24/7. I'm your mentor Manish Mishra and in this session we will discuss 5 more questions from the PIB news. Guys, in today's session the pattern of questions will be quite different. In today's pattern, a passage will be given to you with some hints about a particular scheme and you have to identify the scheme and then answer the given questions. Alright, so now let's begin with the first passage. So there is a passage given to you all and after reading this passage you have to identify the scheme jiski isme baat ho rahi hai and then you have to answer the given question. Alright, so let us first read the passage. In India, over 80% of water is used in irrigation. Of the net sown area of around 140 million hectares, close to half, 68.4 million hectare is irrigated. The rest is rain fed. Government of India is committed to accord high priority to water conservation and its management. To this effect, a scheme has been formulated with the vision of extending the coverage of irrigation, har khet ko pani, and improving water use efficiency, more crop per drop, in a focused manner with end-to-end solution on source creation, distribution, management, field application and extension activities. This scheme has been approved for implementation across the country with an outlay of rupees 50,000 crore in 5 years. Now guys, you have to identify the scheme and answer the given question. Alright, so agar aapne identify kar liya hai to well and good. Let me give you some more hints about the scheme. So this scheme has a nodal ministry, has 3 nodal ministries in fact. One is Jal Shakti Ministry, Jal Shakti Mantralaya, one is Ministry of Rural Development and one is Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare. Okay, so ye 3 nodal ministries milke is scheme ko chala rahi hai and hame clearly yahan se is paragraph se visible hai that the aim of this scheme to extend the coverage of irrigation and improving water use efficiency, and there is also given that an outlay of rupees 50,000 crore in 5 years is provided to this scheme. Now can you identify the scheme guys? Now let me give you one more hint about the scheme. So there is a National Steering Committee headed by the Prime Minister of India, which will provide policy direction to programs, okay, to this program. And there is a National Executive Committee headed by Vice Chairperson of Niti Aayog, which is currently Mr. Rajiv Kumar. This committee will oversee the program implementation at the national level. Now can you identify the scheme? So guys, let me tell you, the name of the scheme is Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, okay, PMKSY. So now let us discuss more about the scheme. So this scheme was launched with an outlay of rupees 50,000 crore over a period of 5 years and it aims to improve on-farm water use efficiency through a number of measures such as micro-irrigation. The Jal Shakti Mantralaya, Ministry of Rural Development and Ministry of Agriculture was made the nodal ministry for implementing the program. Jal Shakti Mantralaya is headed by Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, whose Lok Sabha constituency is Jodhpur. Ministry of Rural Development and Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare is headed by Narendra Singh Tomar, whose Lok Sabha constituency is Morena. Alright, and this scheme has been formulated by amalgamating ongoing schemes which are Accelerated Irrigation Benefit Program, Integrated Watershed Management Program, On Farm Water Management of Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare. Now what was the question? Which among the following programs have not been subsumed under the given scheme? So option A is Accelerated Irrigation Benefit Program, so this is subsumed. Next is Integrated Watershed Management Program, this is also subsumed. Next is On Farm Water Management, this is also subsumed. And next is Rain Fed Area Development. This program was not subsumed under the given scheme, Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana. So the answer to the question is Rain Fed Area Development. So इस तरीके का क्वेश्चन भी एग्जाम में पूछा जा सकता है जिसमें आपको एक पैसेज गिवन होगा एंड यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द स्कीम एंड देन आंसर द गिवन क्वेश्चन. ऑलराइट, नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन अंडर द सेम स्कीम इज अंडर द स्कीम PMKSY Pradhan Mantri Kishi Sinchai Yojana launched with an outlay of Rs 50,000 crore over a period of 5 years. Fund managed is done by the Long Term Irrigation Fund and Micro Irrigation Fund. LTIF, which is Long Term Irrigation Fund, has been set up under which agency? So there is a funding pattern which is managed by Long Term Irrigation Fund and Micro Irrigation Fund. There are two funding patterns which are Long Term Irrigation Fund and Micro Irrigation Fund. So Long Term Irrigation Fund is managed by NABARD. It is managed by NABARD and National Water Development Agency, NWDA, National Water Development Agency. And Micro Irrigation Fund is managed by only NABARD. Alright guys, so there are two funding patterns, Long Term Irrigation Fund and Micro Irrigation Fund. Long Term Irrigation Fund is managed by NABARD and National Water Development Agency, and Micro Irrigation Fund is managed by NABARD. Now this LTIF was set up for completion of 99 irrigation projects. Okay, this was for 99 irrigation projects, and Micro Irrigation Fund, which is managed with NABARD, was set up with an initial corpus of rupees 5,000 crore. This fund was set up to supplement the efforts of per drop more crop component of the scheme Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana. Okay, so LTIF was set up for completion of 99 irrigation projects, and Micro Irrigation Fund was set up with an initial corpus of 5,000 crore to supplement the efforts of per drop more crop component of the given scheme. Alright, so the answer to the question is LTIF has been set up under which agency? So it has been set up under NABARD and NWDA. Therefore, the answer to this question is A and B. Okay. Now, next question under the same scheme is, as per Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana data released recently, which Indian state topped the coverage under micro irrigation in 2019? So under micro irrigation, Tamil Nadu. Okay guys, Tamil Nadu has secured the first position as per the data released by the government of India under Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, and this is by the efforts of the state government of the Tamil Nadu that they had topped the list, and this is being possible by the state government efforts like giving additional subsidy to small and marginal and big farmers and removing 12% GST on micro irrigation components. Micro irrigation components se jo 12% ka GST hai wo Tamil Nadu ki state government ne remove kar diya tha, aur small marginal aur big farmers ko unhone subsidy provide karai thi micro irrigation components mein, jiski wajah se ab micro irrigation mein जो तमिलनाडु है उसने रैंक वन सिक्योर करा है. ऑलराइट, नाउ देयर इज वन मोर पैसेज, यू हैव टू अगेन आइडेंटिफाई द प्रोग्राम. ऑलराइट, नाउ लेट अस फर्स्ट रीड द पैसेज. द इंटरनेशनल ईयर ऑफ सॉइल्स वाज सेलिब्रेटेड इन 2015. द सेम ईयर इंडियाज यूनिक प्रोग्राम वाज लॉन्च ऑन फेब्रुवरी 19 टू असेस द न्यूट्रिएंट स्टेटस ऑफ एवरी फार्म होल्डिंग इन द कंट्री. द स्कीम एम्स एट प्रमोटिंग सॉइल टेस्ट बेस्ड एंड बैलेंस्ड यूज ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर्स टू इनेबल फार्मर्स to realize higher yields at lower cost. Also, the main objective is to aware the growers about the appropriate amount of nutrients for the concerned crop depending on the quality of soil. Now, can you identify the scheme guys? So let me tell you more about this scheme. This scheme was launched in 2015 under Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare, headed by Narendra Singh Tomar, whose Lok Sabha constituency is Morena. Now, under this scheme, the farmers are provided with a card with some printed information on it about the nutrient status of the soil, along with the recommendation on dosage of nutrients. एक तो उसमें nutritional status होता है soil का, साथ ही साथ कितना nutrient soil को provide करना है उसके लिए भी recommendation दिया जाता है. So I hope now you have identified the scheme. The scheme is soil health card scheme. Okay, soil health card scheme. So let us discuss more about this scheme. So this scheme was launched in 2015 under Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. The soil health card informs farmers about nutrient status and recommend on appropriate dosage of nutrients. So this card will contain the status of soil with respect to 12 parameters, which are nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, which are under the category of macronutrients, sulfur under the category of secondary nutrients, zinc, boron, iron, manganese and copper under the category of micronutrients, and pH of soil, electrical conductivity of soil and organic carbon content of the soil under the physical parameters. Now, the card will be issued once in every 2 years to a farm so that nutrient deficiency can be regularly detected and improved, and it was launched with an outlay of around 568 crore for the period of 3 years. Now, what is the pattern of soil sample collection? It is a GPS based unified criteria for collection of soil samples at a grid of 2.5 hectare in irrigated and 10 hectare in rain fed areas throughout the country as per the suggestion of ICAR, Indian Council of Agricultural Research. Now, the scheme is implemented in two phases. In the first phase, from 2015 to 17, 10.73 crore soil health cards have been distributed, and in the second phase, from 2017 to 2019-20, the target is to cover 12.04 crore farmers, and already 11.7 crore soil health cards have been distributed, and the government has spent more than 700 crore rupees on the soil health card scheme since its launch 5 years ago. Now, what was the question? A study conducted by the National Productivity Council. Guys, National Productivity Council is an autonomous non-profit organization, and it was established to promote productivity culture in India. Okay, productivity culture ko promote karne ke liye National Productivity Council banai gayi thi, and it is an autonomous and non-profit organization, and this was established by Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Ministry of Commerce and Industry headed by Piyush Goyal. So this study says that the countrywide application of this program's recommendation has led to a decline of dash in use of chemical fertilizers. So after the application of soil health card program's recommendation, the use of chemical fertilizers in the country has declined to 8 to 10%, and this study also says that there is an enhancement of productivity of 5 to 6% in the country. Okay, jo productivity hai soil ki wo bhi badi hai by a percentage 5 to 6%. Okay, so the answer to this question is 8 to 10%. Now, next question is, what is the age limit for village youth and farmers to set up soil health laboratories and undertake testing under the pilot project development of model villages, a part of soil health card scheme? So this development of model villages, it is a pilot project launched by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare under the soil health card scheme. And under this development of model villages, the soil samples collection has been done at individual farm holding with farmers participation instead of sample collection at grids. Jo soil health card scheme hai usme sample collection grids mein hota hai, but yahan pe development of model village mein individual farms mein jaake farmer ki participation ke saath sample ko collect kiya jayega. And under this project, a model village has been selected for aggregation of soil samples and analysis of each agricultural holding. Also under this scheme, village youth and farmers up to 40 years of age are eligible to set up soil health laboratories and undertake testing, and for that 75% of the fund will be provided by the central and the state governments, and a laboratory can cost up to rupees 5 lakhs. Alright. So the question was, what is the age limit for village youth and farmers to set up soil health laboratories? So the age limit is up to 40 years, B, which is the correct answer to this question. Alright, I hope guys you got this scheme, development of model villages. Okay, so that's it for the today's session. I hope you like the session. For more updates, do subscribe our channel anujindal.in and press the bell icon. Milte hain next session mein. Goodbye, take care, God bless.